Today we'll be discussing problem E from code forces around 538. So the problem is arithmetic progression. What is an arithmetic series? Basically, if you have a series of this form, a comma a plus b, a plus 2d, this is the arithmetic series. So all the terms, adjacent terms, have a common difference of d. Okay. So what you are given is, you are given a number n. Okay. So if n is equals to 4, that means you have 4 number in your arithmetic progression series. Okay. Let us say that the numbers are 14, 19, 24, 29. Okay. So this is your series. In the server, this series is present in a shuffled manner. So the shuffled manner will be say, like any shuffled order of this. So say if we have 19, 24, 29, 14. So this is what the server has. Okay. Now your task is to predict this arithmetic progression. What is this arithmetic progression will be? If you can find out A and B, then it's done. And this is what they are asking for as well. You need to return them the first element and the common difference. If you return them the first element and the common difference, then it is fine. Now, what are the queries that you can make to the server? The first type of query that you can make to the server is whether in this array there is an element greater than x present. What do I mean by that? Say you make a query like, is there a number greater than 25? The server will return true. That yes, it is present. If you make a query like, is there an array number greater than 30 present? It will say false. That no, it is not present. So in this array there is no element greater than 30, but there is an element greater than 25. Okay, this is the first type of query that you can make. Another type of query that you can make is, give me the ith element of this array. This array is already the shuffled form. So if you make the query like, give me a2, okay, so it will return 0, 1, 2, it will give you 29. This is the second type of query that you can make. Keep in mind that the elements that they will be returning will be from the shuffled array. Okay? Otherwise, this problem becomes straightforward. You take first and the second element and you can do this. Okay? So it will return element from the shuffled array. So how will we approach this problem? The another constraint that they have is you can make at most 60 queries, including either of this type or this type. So in total, you have 60 queries to make. The first thing you can see, like, as I said, a plus b and a plus 2d is the form. So what is going to be the nth element of this a? It is going to be a plus n minus 1 into the common difference d. So what is a? The first element is a is equals to a n minus 1 into d. Okay. Now if you can find this a n and this d, as you already have n, so you have n minus 1, then you can return the first element. Now how you can find the last element? By making use of this queries of first type. You can binary search and find the maximum element that is present in this array. How to do that? The maximum element that can be present, or the maximum value of the element given, is 10 to the power 9. So you have 0, you have 10 to the power 9 here. This is your range for binary search. Okay. Now you will find the middle element. You found the mid. Then you will query for this mid. Okay. If it says that yes, there is an element greater than mid present, then what will you do? Then your highest element is going to lie in this range. Mid plus 1 to this 10 to the power 9. Otherwise, where is going to it lie? It is going to lie in 0 to mid. Right? So using this binary search approach, you can find the maximum element. But let us say how many queries will we need. In worst case, how many queries we might need? We have 10 to the power 9, so we might need log base 2 10 to the power 9. These many queries we might need. So this is something 29 point something, which is basically equals to 30. So 30 queries will be used in worst case to find out the maximum element. Now you are left with 30 more queries. So using those 30 more queries, you need to somehow figure out this D. If you can figure out this D, then we are done. Because we have found out this AN, N minus 1 is already there. And if we have D, we can find A, and we are finding D as well. So now the whole task is finding D. Okay? Now, the one thing to do here is, I will make a random query. As I can pass an index here, right? I will make a proper random query of these indexes. If I make a proper random query and if I get 30 more elements from this shuffled array, okay, then the claim is that if we find the GCD of all those 30 elements, then it is going to be our common difference. Now, if we make a proper random distribution of the indices and we ask the server to give us those elements, then with very high probability this is going to be the answer. Now for proof, you can follow the link in the description. There it has the mathematical proof that why this probability is going to be very very high, that we are always going to get the answer from this, but the answer is going to be this only. So for this question, all you need to do is run a binary search, find the maximum element, okay, and take consume at max 30 queries for that, and find the GCD of the remaining 30 queries using the elements from the queries. Okay, so this was all for this problem. For implementation detail, you can follow the link in the description. Happy coding.